quite the claim to say you are the happiest place on Earth. The happiest place on Earth!
Come on, kid, you can do it.
I decided to get out of my house for once and shoot some of this top five on location. It'll be just like that episode of Full House when they go to Disney World, except I won't be getting a princess makeover and John Stamos won't be singing me any romantic songs. I don't think. So throw on your Mickey ears. Here are the top five Disney park video games. Number 5, Walt Disney World Quest Magical Racing Tour. Hey, it's the Disney version of Mario Kart, starring Chip and Dale in their Rescue Rangers outfits, plus a bunch of characters you've never heard of and will never see again, like Amanda Sparkle? Most kart racers tell you to just get in your buggy and floor it, but this one actually has a story. Chip and Dale are on a mission to fix the Disney World fireworks machine. Yeehaw! Who the hell put chipmunks in charge of pyrotechnics? All the tracks are themed to Disney World attractions, such as Space Mountain, Big Thunder Mountain, Splash Mountain, Pirates of the Caribbean, you know, all the ones people actually care about. Even the carts are themed.
Shh, please keep your hands and feet inside your doom buggies.
Basically, if you'd like to experience Mario Kart with mouse balloons instead of question mark bubbles, and Jiminy Cricket instead of Koopa Troopa, get your lead finger ready because you're in luck. Hi, Sean.
Hi.
You having fun at Disneyland?
I'm not on a ride, they are.
Oh.
Actually, there's no one there.
Do you want to go on a ride?
Yes.
Okay, let's go. Woo!
Number 4, Mickey No Tokyo Disneyland Daiboken. In other words, Mickey's Great Adventure in Tokyo Disneyland, an awesome platformer for the Super Famicom, which, as you can guess, was exclusive to Japan. If you loved Castle of Illusion or Magical Quest, you're going to be drooling over this game. Like Pluto when he watches Mickey eat short-line beef cuts. Mickey takes a trip to Tokyo Disneyland, only to discover that Pete has kidnapped all his friends because that's what Pete does! He's been doing it since 1928! Naturally, Mickey must go and save all of his incompetent friends in this gorgeous side-scrolling platformer, using his ever-powerful balloons of both the water and helium variety. Oh, but don't be too broken up about not getting this in the States. This game was hard as crap! Number 3, Adventures in Magic Kingdom. Dress up like Indiana Jones, experience 5 different stages of gameplay, explore a park that looks oddly like Disneyland, not Disney World. It's true, the map and positioning of the attractions mimics Disneyland, not Disney World, aka the Magic Kingdom. But don't worry, it has tons of redeeming qualities. As for those game modes, no repetitive gameplay here. Autopia is a top-down racer, Space Mountain is like first-person asteroids, Pirates of the Caribbean is a side-scrolling pirate adventure, and Haunted Mansion is a similar platformer, but with ghosts and stuff! The only one that's lame is Big Thunder Mountain, which has you controlling a train on a track, and you quickly have to choose which track when you reach the fork in the road, and it's dumb and totally lame and completely based on luck. But above all, the coolest thing about this game is how it incorporates Disney trivia. And why shouldn't it? Recalling weird, obscure facts is what Disney nerds love most. That and lanyards with pins on them. Number 2, Kinect Disneyland Adventures. Why spend thousands of dollars on plane tickets, hotel rooms, and in-park turkey legs when your Xbox can bring Disneyland directly to you? Disneyland Adventures is an open-world game of colorful exploration that is so realistic, it will have any 5-year-old crying at the sight of giant Goofy as if he were actually right there in the living room, instead of miles away, safely locked up in Disney jail for the night. Many of your favorite Disney voices can be heard as they interact with your virtual avatar, and it wouldn't be a Kinect game if it wasn't chock full of mini-games. Kinect, I hate you, but you done D-Land proud. I'm just happy I can have a real theme park experience without baby strollers running into my ankles every 5 minutes. And the number one Disney park video game? It's the MMO we loved and lost, Virtual Magic Kingdom. We dedicated so many hours to it only to have it walk out the front door with our dog and the keys to our Mercedes. VMK was a browser-based free-to-play MMO that lasted way longer than expected or intended. It was launched in 2005 as simply a promotional shindig, but don't underestimate the power of Disney nuts, people loved it! The virtual park actually had opening and closing hours too, just like the real parks, but sadly one of those closing times was its last. Disney shut down VMK in 2008 and fans were outraged, there was complaints and petitions, they staged a protest, which only about 15 people showed up to. Sadly, VMK seems gone for good, but it was a very cool, very fun game for a while that celebrated social interaction, video gaming, and Disney love all at once. VMK fans, just be thankful you got to play it, and be even more thankful that you no longer have to avoid Donald Duckinit 55, who keeps following you around asking, ASL? Look, he's totally Donald Duckinit. That's it for the Disneyland episode of Top 5. Tweet all your love, hate, and respectful disagreements to @LisaFoyles, and I will see you next week for another Top 5.
Do you believe in magic? In a young girl's heart, how the music can free her whenever it starts, and it's magic. If the music is groovy, it makes you feel happy like an old-time movie.
There it is. Submarine, the worst ride at Disneyland.
That's the ride where they said, let's put people in a tube underwater. They'll love it. I'll tell you about the man.